needs that a mom is expected to provide to their children. Michelle, you want to start?
For me, I think it's a strong foundation. I think it's love. My kids need love. I want them to know that even if they have the hardest day outside, they can always come home to a loving home. And I will not judge them. I will not be judgmental towards their problem. I actually try to be a friend to them and get to know their friends. So we have a good relationship with all the other kids besides just mine. I try to understand their problems, and of course I tell them to do the right thing. So in that way they have a choice to choose between doing the right thing and of course not doing the right thing. So with the guidance of the church influence and the church friends and the church activities, I personally have not had a very tough time raising these teens.
Okay. Million, do you want to add to that?
Yes, besides the mother knowing that we are providing with our physical needs, good food, discipline them to a fixed time of sleep so that they have enough sleep. Emotional support is a, I see that it's a needs in them, emotional support, that we will have a time to listen to them when they speak out their hearts, and we will give them the word of comfort to them, so they will feel to them, who are nearest and a mark to a kids. If we don't, as our sister, we shall share that. We don't judge them. We don't judge them and listen to them. And lend a shoulder if they cry. Okay? And really be comfortable to them.
That's great. Mom?
For me, I think I'm sharing what has happened about 20 or 30 years ago. Now I'm also bringing up my grandchildren. So for me, I feel I'm their best friend. So they can come home and share everything to me. They don't hide anything. Even my children don't do that. Because I always say that I have to be a listening ear to them. And yes, we do the normal things, good food, family time. I don't think we had time to have family time because they were all studying. And there are mother's time, yes. They come to me for everything. But other than that, I think the same usual things what the others have shared. A good home, a loving mother, and a spiritual mother. Because we are the role models for our children and our grandchildren. And I feel that's the main thing that we look for, especially our children. And we can see it in our children and grandchildren.
刚才主持人问到一个问题，他说：“你认为妈妈应该为孩子提供哪一些重要的兴趣？”这样我们听过的三位妈妈，我大概总结一下：这样他们大姐他们讲到，最重要是孩子是需要爱，哦，爱是很重要，因为爱成为那一种的根基在这个家庭里面。 还有他讲到就是了，不要有那种，不要让孩子觉得是那种被审判的感觉。如果他做错了，不要让他总就感觉就是我一直被讲，我是一直在重复，他一直在说我做错了，要给他一种了解，然后成为他们的朋友，就成为他们的朋友，聆听他们，就是说他们的需要，聆听他们所经历的，然后就是说，让他们能够自由的去能够做出一些的选择，因为。 就是说，无论他们是做错或者是做对，他们有这个选择。刚才有一个很重要的，就是这一个的，就是说，我们的周世斌姐妹，她讲了一个很重要的，就是除了这一些的，这一些在家里面这一些重要的需求以外呢，最重要就是他。
Alright, so I think one important aspect that was mentioned is being a spiritual leader, right? Spiritual mom, which is really important, you know, just investing in your children, planting that seed, and you know, all these godly moms have done that because all their children are in church serving. And you know, I'm sure of all things, my mother wouldn't have thought that this one would become a pastor among her four daughters. She's probably wondering what happened, but you know, it's important from young what you plant in your kids at that time that you invest in your children. Okay, so we spoke about what children need. What do you think children do not need? Michelle?
My kids don't need headphones. I really think it's a major source of negative influence. Like now we have Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and this so-called PUBG game that we're always on it. And all the social media are not filtered and have no governance. So what I have done, I have actually taken away their phones from Monday to Friday, and they only get their phones on Friday night. That if they have completed their chores and done everything and been good throughout the week. So Sunday night, phones back on my table.
Very good. Vijay, what do you think children do not need?
The same also, handphone. It's going to bother me as a mother if seeing them addicted to the phones because they do not really need computer games.
I'm not addicted.
To see God, they have to really use their quiet heart and quiet mind. So if they have been using only the senses of their eyes, just playing games, they do not really use other senses for their whole beings to come to know God. So games is really bringing them to addiction. And they cannot come to know their power of mind. And they cannot develop a focusing power because they're bringing them this addiction. Games will keep their mind in prisons. They can't experience the creations of God.
Mom?
Talking about 20 years ago.
Handphones then.
We didn't have handphones then, so I had no problem with it. I am the phone for them.
Is good.
No, this time they need.
Yeah.
Because harm in giving them a handphone and telling them how important it is. You know, it's not easy. But to keep it and use it for something that you need, emergency call or something, you need a handphone. You can't be running to the telephone booth or anything. No. You want your daughter to run across the school to the telephone booth.
I don't think they have telephone booths. They still have telephone booths out there.
Discipline them is because I want to mold them to be a better person. And what I what I do actually is I really try to be a friend to them. You know, what's important is really to know your friends, who are their circle of friends, what do they do, what are their interests, and I speak to them a lot. And you know, I know that they are very close to God, because like if they have a problem, I know they always pray and tell them to pray about it, and you know, they'll be able to overcome. So as long as your kid has God in them, and we install that in them, and be your friend, and like what I said, not be judgmental towards them, that's very important to be a strong teenager.
So what is your greatest challenge now that your kids are teenagers and young adults compared to when they were much younger? So what's the key challenge now?
Aisha not having a boyfriend. No. Okay. I really don't. I've never yet experienced anything really like, you know, those other mothers would experience. I think my kids are pretty in good straight line now. They understand me and I understand them, and they know from wrong and right. So I think we'll be probably, you know, they just trying to get the right things, time for God, time for the studies, time for the family, you know. I don't really have challenge.
Lucky mother. Okay, ma, be careful what you share. But think back 20 over years. And what, see your daughter's making noise in the other room. How do you approach parenting? And I know we're not teenagers, but at the different phases that you've had four girls, share some, how would you love and encourage your older daughters in becoming people that they are now?
Actually, I didn't have any problems with my daughters. It is true, you can ask them. Of course, they have their own failures and weaknesses, but not that big for me to deal with, because they were always there, and I was their best friend. And I always tell my daughters, you know, if you have any problems, tell me, I'm your best friend. If you go and tell another friend of yours, the whole world will know about you. So it's best that you tell your mother. She will advise you, she will pray for you, and everything will go well. And they were all listening to me at that time. And of course now they are different. They are all strong adults. It's the grace of God. Because I always make sure that I'm with them, I pray with them, I pray for them. So it was always God's grace, His amazing grace upon them, that what they are today. It's not my own. I don't think I could have done it on my own, but without God's help, no. But with God's help, all these girls have grown up and they are somebody today. And I'm really proud of it, because God was with me.
教养这个青少年呢，就是说，他一定。
Falling apart when they are in trouble.
That's superb advice, right? So get your children involved in church. You know, that's where they grow, they meet like-minded, you know, kids their age. But yeah, that's great advice. Mom?
I speak to all the young mothers, old mothers, and I say to them, be a good role model for your children. Be a spiritual mother, and also walk in the path of righteousness, and your children will follow you. So be a role model. Let them not look up other things. Like once I asked a friend of mine, her daughter, what would you like to be when you grow up? She said, I want to be like Siti Nolisa, the singer. I said, what about your mother? She's your role model. So I think we shouldn't give wrong advices or wrong things for them to see and hear. You be the role model for them. You be a good mother, a spiritual mother, and that your children will follow you. My granddaughter once wrote a conversation in school, long time ago, a few months ago. And the question was, who is your role model and why? And you know what she wrote? Not her mother, but she said, my role model is my grandmother.
Oh.
And I was very proud because I asked her, why did you write this? She said, because you're always there for me. You're my best friend. I can talk to you, I can listen to your advice, and you also pray for me during exams. You are there for me every time. My mom is working very hard and she comes back very late. She has no time for me. So she spends only a few hours with me. So I said to her, because your mother is working so hard to give you the good things in life, so you must now try and make your mother be the role model. She said, yes, I will try. And I feel that I should tell you all mothers, spend time with your children.
Yes,
listen to them. Give them time. You be the best mother for them, best friend for them, and a good role model. Not anything else. And your children will never go wrong.
Okay. 这个中原就是说最宝贵的中原能够鼓励我们所有的这些的母亲呢，这样一定要分享，就是首先呢，要爱自己，你一定要爱自己，你就是要去做上帝来到得到这个能力，就是说，因为对这个能力，在你的家里面是非常非常的重要，就有时候孩子他做一些奇怪的事情，就是说，只要自己就是说靠着上帝的恩典，靠着上帝的爱来到。 有时这些事情，上帝会带领哦。这样你需要的方，这他所分享就是呢，这个重点就是一定要有一个好的根基。这个根基就是要邀请上帝来到这个家庭里面，把所有就是说小孩子，就是说青少年他们自己孩子的活动，一定要有上帝的这个同在，包括他们去这些的青少年营啊。 他们这一些的一些青少年的团去这种这样的聚会，把它放在上帝里面，把青少年把孩子放在上帝里面，这个就是他就是说看管孩子，他对每一位母亲的忠言。就我们来到啊，其实主日呢，他所给我们一个母亲的这个的忠告就是呢，要做一个好的榜样，要走在上帝的道里面。
走在上帝的这个安排里面，要做一个属灵的妈妈，要懂得如何去亲近我们的这个上帝。他有一个见证刚才他说到，就是说，这个他的孙女有一次在学校，这学校这老师也问他，学生你是这一个最好学习的榜样。像这一个的孙女他就讲到了，其实我最好学习的榜样就是我的外婆。 然后为什么是外婆呢？因为呢，在任何的时候有困难的时候呢，我的外婆就是在那边听我的问题，我的外婆就在那边听我的和我一起祷告。这个就是可以看到你，至少他的忠告也是陪着孩子成长，陪着孩子成长，使到他你能够有时间和他一起，就是花时间一起，能够和他一起祷告。这个的做法，孩子就会出差错。
So not easy being a mother, right? In this age, you know, we don't have sometimes a luxury of being a stay-at-home mom, although it's so much work staying at home and taking care of kids. But we also have to juggle, you know, some of you are career moms. And sometimes we feel guilty that we're not spending enough time with our kids because we also have to be at work, and then, you know, you always have this whole juggling act to do, right? You know, whether you spend enough time, you know, investing in your children, whether you're spending enough time, you know, juggling a full-time job. So it's not easy, right? So I think sometimes moms that have the tendency to feel guilty as well, you know, if we spend a lot of time on ourselves, you know, but I think like what Milian says, it's important to also, you know, love yourself, take care of yourself, because you need to take care of your kids. We have jobs as well. You know, I know Michelle works very long hours, you know, but also coming home and being with your children, and which is important, right? But yeah, I think being a mother is not easy, as you know what these three ladies have shared their experiences with us. But I think what's important and the key message here is, you know, having God at the center of our lives, because we can't do everything, right? We're not omnipresent. We can't, you know, juggle so many things, but, you know, having God as the center and ensuring that our children are planted and they know God is important, is really one of the critical factors in being a good mother.
其实我们做母亲的也是，我们会觉得很内疚，因为我们有时候不能够花足够的时间和孩子在一起。我们觉得我们因为我们要在外面工作，可是我们最重要就是很多时候就是要把上帝呢放在我们的生命里面，让上帝能够在这个家庭里面呢做他掌管的工作，能够让他来到带领这个家庭。就是说，因为在现在在这个世界，就是说父母亲都需要工作。 让上帝来到，在这个家庭里面带领我们，使到我们能够有这个聪明和智慧呢，去教导我们的孩子。
Amen. In Proverbs, you know, 31, it says, it talks about a woman, right, being a wife, being a mother. I think what's important in that verse, it says, her children arise and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many women do noble things, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So we've got really strong God-fearing mothers here today with us who have shared. I hope that every one of you have been blessed by their sharing, their open and honest sharing. So thank you very much, Milian, Michelle, Mom. And I hope that, you know, every one of you are blessed by what they have shared from their hearts. Amen.